Hi, I'm Amanda Harding, graduate student at Norfolk State University. Today I'll be demonstrating the Vico DecTech 6M Profilometer. This instrument is used to measure step heights. After the computer has been turned on, we can go ahead and turn the instrument on, which is a switch in the back of the instrument. So we want to turn the DecTech 32 program on. So once the program is loaded up, we'll click on the left menu, the sample positioning button. And that brings up a screen that will show us the camera view of the sample stage. So the next step is to load our sample. So we'll open the chamber. Inside we have the rotating sample stage. It's adjustable with a few of these knobs here, and then also it turns. So we'll place our sample. And then back on the program, we'll click on this button here, which is the tower down to null position. And that will lower the stylus onto our sample. And as you can see, the camera on the instrument is picking up the view of our sample and the stylus touching it. The brightness is pretty high usually, so we can turn it down and then bring it back up to where we can see much better. These two knobs move the stage back and forth, front to back, and then this dial actually rotates the stage in a circle. So we'll rotate the sample, get it in correct position for the measurement. So we'll close the chamber and go back to the program. The sample that we're using is a calibration standard, and this height here is what we're measuring. So we want to set up the stylus so that it's going to go across our sample. And the stylus is up right now a little bit off of the sample so that it doesn't scratch or damage the stylus. But it's going to come down right about in the middle of these crosshairs. So that's how we can line up our sample. So the next step would be go to the Window tab, click on Scan Routines, and this is where we can change the parameters for our scan. So we'll enter an ID, the length of the scan, the duration of the scan. Changing those two parameters will also automatically change the resolution. And the force of the stylus, we can change based on what kind of sample we have. So if we have a soft sample, we'll want to use a low force. And if we have something like a hard sample, we know we aren't going to damage it, we can use a higher force, and then we will get better resolution. The measurement range is basically if we have any idea of what height to expect from our features. So we know this one is fairly small. We'll choose 65 kiloangstroms. The profile is also what you're expecting. If you don't really know what to expect, you can choose hills and valleys, or if you know you're measuring the depth of a scratch, for example, you can use valleys, or if you know that you're trying to measure the height of a step height, you can choose hills, and that's what we're doing. So then we'll go back to Window, click on Sample Positioning, and click on Scan in the left side. And that will begin the scan. So in this box, you can see in the background is the camera view of the scan actually taking place. And in the front is this graph that shows the data that's being acquired from the instrument. So the scan's complete. And now we just see the data. A lot of times when we do these measurements, the instrument doesn't pick up on how level our sample is, so we'll want to level it. We can use these two cursors, R and M. We'll put them on two points that we know should be level. So these two points we know should be level, and we'll click in this toolbar on level the trace at the current R and M cursor intercepts. So now we have something that's level. So something to note about this instrument, it measures very small features. So while you have a scale of microns that goes in the horizontal direction of your sample, the vertical direction of your sample will be on the scale of angstroms. So once we're ready to take measurements of our scan, we'll use these lines, this R line it goes all the way vertically up and down the scan, and the M line. And what we'll do is we'll move these two lines in order to make our measurements. So we'll take the cursor, we grab the R, and that moves the entire line. We'll put it at the base of our measurement. And we'll take the M line and move it to the top of the feature. And now we'll be able to determine the vertical height of the feature. And that information is located right here, vertical D. And that measurement is 1,002 angstroms. We can also measure the width of our feature. We move the R line and the M lines just to the edges of our feature. We'll see the horizontal distance between them is about 208 microns. So when we finish our scan, we can go up to File, Save As. We'll go into the data file, which is located on the desktop. You can find your folder, or if you don't have a folder, you can name one. You may want to use another folder with today's date, and then you can save your sample. So when we're finished, we'll go to the Window tab and the Sample Positioning button. And we'll go over here to the Tower Up to Load Position button. Click that, and that will bring the stylus out of the way so that you can remove your sample.